Hi. So, now you know which things you should take into account when selecting a host. Now let's see how things actually work in practice. We can't cover it all because things work just a little differently for each hosting company. In this screencast, we'll show you how it works for SiteGround. Not because we think this is the best hosting company or the biggest or the cheapest. We do think it's a good host, but it sure is not the only one. In fact, we've created a list for you on yoast.com/wordpress-hosting, and this list contains only reliable and dedicated WordPress hosts. This list could be a good starting point when you're trying to find a host that fits your specific needs. Anyway, we chose SiteGround for this video because it's on this list, and we have experience with this host ourselves, and therefore we could show you more details of the practical process. Now, let's get started with the practical part. Let's click this link to get some more information on our example host, SiteGround. Here you can see some features. It comes with free SSL. We've talked about this before, it makes your site more secure. So that's included. A CDN is also very useful. It can improve the loading speed of your site. And we'll come back to that in a later module about WordPress SEO. Next, you can see the PHP version SiteGround supports. PHP is important for your site speed as well, and for security too. PHP is the programming language that's used to build and maintain WordPress. WordPress itself encourages updating to its recommended version, which is PHP 7.3 right now, which is the latest version. So we're good because 7.3 is the default version for this host. Now, there's more to read on this page about the admin interface, support-related things, and the locations of the server, and how this host gives back to the community. Let's assume that we've read all of this, it feels right, and you want to know what plans this host offers. Let's click this link to visit the actual site of SiteGround and find out more. Ah, WordPress hosting, yes. That's what I'm looking for. Let's click it. Officially recommended by WordPress.org. That's always good. Now, it seems that they offer three different plans. Startup, Grow Big, and Go Geek. Of course, each plan has a different price tag. Questions you have to ask yourself. How many websites do I have? How many web space do I need? How many visitors do I expect? Let's say the startup plan fits my needs best. Take a look at the extra features over here. Free WordPress install. Okay, so the installation of WordPress is taken care of. Free WordPress migrator. Okay, if I already have a site and I want to migrate it to this host, then my host will take care of it. Free SSL and HTTPS, there it is again. Free email, free CDN, free daily backups, and of course a lot more. Let's scroll down a bit to see what's there. On the left, more information about launching a new WordPress website. We save you the trouble of downloading, installing, and configuring WordPress manually by offering a simple click and install option. That's nice. No technical knowledge required. Great. On the right, you can learn more about how to transfer or migrate an existing site from another host to this host. And over here, you can find more information about security and updates and performance. Now, let's say I've done my research and I've made up my mind. It's going to be the startup plan for me. So, get me that plan. As you can see, I've selected my plan. And step two is to choose a domain name. If you want to register your domain here for this price, then enter your domain name here and select your TLD. As we've said before, you don't have to register your domain with your hosting account if you don't want to. You can register your domain elsewhere too, or maybe you already have an existing site with the registered domain name. In both cases, you can click the other option, enter your domain name, and then proceed. In my case, let's say I want to register a new domain. Let's enter the details one more time. and click Proceed. Ah, and it's still available. That's of course not always the case. For example, let's enter Yoast.com to see what happens. This domain is already taken. So let's stick to everydayimtraveling.com. Step 3 is review and complete. Fill in your details, check your order, which is in this case a startup plan for 12 months and domain registration, and then pay. Done! What happens next, again, depends on the hosting company you've chosen. Maybe you're redirected to your hosting account directly, or maybe you'll receive an email with instructions to log in somewhere. In the next video, we'll show you how it works for SiteGround.